Welcome back to Switch to Linux. Well, today I want to talk briefly about the DRM in the Linux kernel 5.18 that a few people have mentioned over the last week or two on the weekly news roundup. This is an important discussion, and what I wanted to do here is say that wrong DRM is the basic summary of what we're talking about, as far as I understand. Now, this is actually a hardware DRM, so I could be wrong because I'm not a hardware guy. So someone out like Wendell at Level 1 Tech comes out and basically completely contradicts me. Believe him over me, I would be wrong. But as far as what I understand, doing as much research as I could, this is not DRM, digital rights management, which is the bad DRM, which we don't want embedded. So that type of DRM, you have a media file. It is encrypted in such a way that you cannot utilize it in an open source platform. You need a proprietary blob to decode it to play it on your system. That is the bad DRM. That's the DRM that we've talked about on this channel before that has a lot of negative consequences and abusive issues behind it. That is not the DRM that's being put inside the Linux kernel. What is the DRM being used in the Linux kernel relates to graphics drivers. And if I remember correctly, it stands for direct relay management or something like that. Basically, it has to do with how the graphics cards are going to interface with the kernel. We talked recently about NVIDIA with hell freezing over, where NVIDIA is starting to open source some of the drivers, starting with the Linux headers. That is, to my understanding, exactly what this is dealing with. So what it is that there is a way to directly access the firmware on the graphics cards, and in order to make graphics cards work better, Linux has always put all forms of drivers in. Well, this is just a different way of managing those drivers. It is not proprietary blobs. All of this is all open source information. Torvalds has grabbed the information and personally put it in. He is pretty much against anything proprietary being in the kernel. So this is not some proprietary DRM, some frightening thing being embedded in the Linux kernel. This has to do with the fundamental principles needed to make your graphics drivers work better. Now, as I said, I could be wrong because I am not a hardware guy. I'm not really a graphics guy. I don't really pay a whole lot of attention to a lot of that stuff, mostly because for me, I just need my systems to work. I do free and open source wherever I can, but to me, it's not a hill worth dying on. I'd rather have my system working well with the kernel without installing anything else. Now, is there anything proprietary in this particular kernel patch? Best I can tell, the answer is no. So I think a lot of people realize and recognize DRM as a bad thing, and to see DRM being implemented in the kernel, people have said, oh my lord, they're putting bad stuff in the Linux kernel, and I don't think that that's what's going on. Completely different DRM. Yeah, if they were putting some proprietary blobs for media codecs decrypting inside of it, yeah, we'd have a problem. But that would appear to not be the issue. Now, again, look around for other people who are more into the hardware and are more into the programming, because I am not into either one of them. I focus mostly on the software and making sure that things are working for a business world or your basic life. I'm not the one tinkering and tweaking and making stuff work for the most part. So if somebody else contradicts this and says, this is why it's really bad, that proceeds, oh, it's DRM, DRM's bad, therefore Linux kernel equals bad. That's a false argument, okay? But if somebody actually has solid evidence to the contrary, let me know in the comments. For now, we're going to go ahead and leave this short video here. I did just want to address that, say I did research it. I looked at Torvald's notes. I looked at the other notes. All this is related to is better management of graphics cards. So if I'm wrong, let me know down below, but give me actual reasons, not, DRM bad, because it's a different type of DRM. So let me know down below. So thanks for watching, guys, and we should be back with a full video on Wednesday.
Thank you for watching this video from Switched to Linux. This channel would not be possible without the backing of the program supporters scrolling on the screen now. you can be a supporter at Patreon at patreon.com/TOMM or at thinklifemedia.com. I also want to thank the open source community who creates such excellent software that makes producing this show possible. Please remember to support your software communities. Thank you, and I hope that you enjoy switching to Linux.